The former president of Cape Verde, Antonio Montero, is getting down to business as he takes on a new role as nutrition advocate in West Africa. In this region, around 600,000 children under the age of 5 die from causes related to malnutrition every year.
La malnutrition est un fléau qui assole le continent.
Malnutrition is a disease that wipes out our continent, which reaches especially our sub-region, and this must be fought with force and determination. It's for this reason that I said yes, and I am available to participate in this effort to fight against malnutrition in West Africa.
Over the last few years, regional leaders have made great strides in trying to combat malnutrition. For instance, some countries have recorded 2- to 3-fold increases in the percentage of women exclusively breastfeeding their children under 6 months of age. And some 180 million people today in the region consume fortified foods. But more still needs to be done from the highest levels of government to push through the message that nutrition is key to a country's overall development.
We're really poised now to get the level of political commitment from heads of state to go from a number of promising to experience to just a really massive scale up of these key nutrition programs. And to me, that's what's so exciting about having this opportunity of having a nutrition advocate of the stature of President Montero to really be able to dialogue at the highest political levels of, yes, undernutrition poses enormous challenges in West Africa, but West Africa is incredibly well positioned to do something about it.
Among the 15 countries in the world with the worst under 5 mortality statistics, 7 are in West Africa, where 1 out of 4 children is underweight. In areas like the Sahel, the situation is aggravated by cycles of acute deprivation due to drought and crop failure. Malnutrition can not only have severe consequences for the well-being of people, in particular the most vulnerable like women and children, but can also impact the broader economy of a country.
If the child is malnourished at early childhood, they have irreversible consequences later on. We have consequences in terms of education. We know that they lose 2 or 3 years of schooling, and sometimes they don't make it. That is one. The second, it's about the economic growth. We know that the country loses 2 to 3% of GDP by not investing on nutrition.
The hope is that Mr. Montero, who is supported by a regional group of UN agencies, non-governmental organizations and donors, will be able to encourage the leaders in West African countries to take charge of the gains they've already made and put nutrition much higher up on their development agenda.